Good morning. Number of our participants increasing fast. And let's wait a couple minutes. Okay, let's start. Good morning to everyone. Today, our topic today, it's how can we represent integers? And let's recall integer, it means natural numbers, 1, 2, 3, and so on, 0, and negative numbers, opposite numbers of natural numbers. By the way, there is a little confusing terminology. In English, there is phrase whole number, but whole number, it's not this what we have in Georgian language. Whole number in English literature, it just means natural numbers, 1, 2, 3, and so on, and 0. This is whole number. And as for integer, integer, it means, in Georgian, what we mean in Georgian, whole number, this is in English literature, this is called integer. So it's a little confusing terminology, and be aware about it. Okay, and today our topic is, how represent integer in the computer? And before
I tell him to decode the log.
Sorry. So before starting our new topic, let's recall about binary system. Some of you may know, have knowledge about binary system. How can we convert binary numbers to decimal number? And how, vice versa, how to convert decimal number?
Learn about this in computer programming.
Yeah, David, you are right.
So, okay, so the first number is 2 to the power of 0, which is 1. Then the next number is 2 to the power of 2, which 2 to the power of 1. Which is
yes,
two,
absolutely.
Then 4 then 8. And then 1 means that you add the number, 0 means that you don't add the number, and you can write out a code for any number using this method.
Yes, you are right, absolutely. And you know, in everyday life, we use decimal number system, but digital world has binary nature. Because everything we can describe in binary system. In binary system, we have only 2 digits, 1 and 0. And let's share my screen. By the way, today I testing my new device, USB port, and hope it will be successful testing. In previous classes, I did use my phone Samsung N series, and there is possible to write down by S Pen. But today I have new device, USB, and the advantage of this device is that it's larger than phone. So when we have, for example, when we have number 3, 4, 7 in the decimal system, we know that this number we can represent as 3 times 10 square plus 4 times 10 and plus 7 times 10 in the power 0. Similarly, when we have binary number, for instance, we have 1011 in the binary system, we can represent it like 1 times 2 in the power. So now pay attention. In previous example, we have 3 digit. We had 3 digit numbers, and greatest power it was 2. Now we have 4 digit number, and greatest power of base is going to be 3. So 1 times 2 in the power 0 plus 0 times 2 in the power 2 plus 1, 2 in the power 1 and finally 1 times 2 in the power 0. We can just skip it because 0 times anything, it's 0. And now we can calculate it. 8 plus 2, 10, 10 plus 1, it's 11. So this is example How can we convert binary number to the decimal number? Okay. Now, let's now make some table between some correspondence between binary number and decimal numbers. So, decimal zero in the binary, it's zero again. Decimal one, we can represent it one times 2 to the power 0. Similarly, we have here one digit, one, it's one digit, and one times 2 to the power 0, so it's binary one. Okay. Next, 2. Two we can represent at 1 times plus 0 times 2 to the power 0, and this is binary 10. So similarly, we can 3. What will be 3 in the binary system? Please be active to help me. And if you will switch on videos, it will help me.
1-1.
1-1, absolutely. This is 1-1. 1-1 in the binary system. And we can explain it 1 times 2 to the power 1 plus 1 times 2 to the power 0. So it's 3. Okay. Next, 4.
0, 0, 1.
Absolutely. It's not 0, 0, but 1, 0, 0, David.
Okay, 1, 0, 0.
1, 0, 0. Okay, very good. Okay, what is 5? 5, it's going to be 1, 0, 1. Absolutely. And we can explain it again. It's 1 times 2 to the power 2 plus, we can just skip this 2 to the power 1 and just write down, because we have here 0 and we can write, but we can skip it. So I can write 1 times 2 to the power 0, and it's going to be 5. Decimal 5. Okay. What is next? Next is 6. And what do you think? What is 6?
1, 1, 0.
1, 1, 0. Okay. 7. It's 1, 1, 1. 8. What is 8?
1, 0, 0, 0.
Yes. 8 is 1, 0, 0, 0. And I want to pay your attention that, for example, in the decimal number, when we have 10 to the power 3, it's denoted as 1 and 3 0, 1000. Very similar case we have in the binary system. 8, we know it's 2 to the power 3, and it's 1 and 3 0. The same we have here, 4. 4, it's 2 to the power 2, and it we can write down as one and two zeros. Moreover, in the decimal system, if from 1,000 we will subtract one, we get three nines. Nine, nine, nine. Very similar we have in the binary system. When we subtract, for instance, 2^3 minus one, in the binary system, we can write it as 3 ones, 1, 1, 1. In the binary system. Okay, the same we can see in case of decimal three. Decimal three, it's 2^2 - 1, and it's 1, 1. Okay, what do you think? How can I write down 63 in the binary system?
Six times 10 plus 3 × 10^0.
Yes, I can represent, I always, but I mean to consider it a special case. And special case, I mean that it's 2^6 minus one. 2^6, you know, it's 64. And 63 is 2^6 minus one. So since it's 2^6 minus one, we can represent it as how?
6 × 1.
Certainly. We can represent as 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1. So they are special case. Okay. As for 32, how can we represent 32 in the binary system? 32.
5 ones.
Oh, not 5 ones, but this is, it's 2^5, 2^5, and 2^5, we can represent in 1 and 5 zeros. Like 10^5 in the decimal system. We can represent it 1 and 5 zeros. Very similar with this. As for 5 ones, we have, what will be 5 ones in the decimal, by the way? I will write down here.
33.
1, 1, 1, 1, 1, binary. What will be this in the decimal system?
31.
31. Yes, it's going to be 31. It's less than 32 by 1. Okay, very good. So now, so we very close that we know how to convert any decimal number, any binary number to the decimal number, beyond special cases. For instance, we have 1, 1, 0, 1, 1. Please help me to write down it, to represent it as powers of two, and then find correspondence decimal number. One times two, in which power two?
Four.
Yes, absolutely. 2 in the power 4. 2 in the power 4 plus 1 times 2 in the power 3. Then we have 0 and I will skip 2 in the power 2 and 1 in the power 1 and 0 and 1 in the power 1 times 2 in the power 0. So I will add this in the decimal system and we will get converting value of binary system. Okay, let me to continue here. We found that decimal 8, this is 1 and zeros. Okay, I will erase here. Any questions so far? Okay. Okay, decimal 9. Decimal 9 is going to be 1001. And we can check it. And as for 10, what is 10? What is your idea?
1010.
Very good. It's 1010. So we can guess that we can add 1.
Nego.
About addition, we will talk very soon. Now let's finish up it. I want to write down up to 16, because later we will discuss also hexadecimal number system. Hexadecimal number system, it's a number system with base 16. So in the number system with base 16, how many digits we need?
16.
We need 16 digits. And how many digits we have? We have notation only 10 digits. Yes. So it's going to be 1 and 12. So it's, what will be 12? If we will add, and at the same time, let's talk about addition in the binary system. For example, 1, 1, 1. And I want to add 1. So 1 plus 1. Addition, it's very similar with addition in the decimal system. For instance, if we want to add 15 and 17. By the way, many years ago, when I heard first about RAM, random access memory, RAM of computer, I asked one smart man, I asked him, what hell is this RAM? And he explained me like this. For example, you want to add 15 and 17, 5 plus 7, it's 12, but you write down 2 and carry 1. And to carry 1, you can, because you have RAM. So I don't know how professional is this explanation, and but I remember it till today. So we carry one, then 1 plus 1, it's 2, and it's 32. Very similar, we have here 1 plus 1, it's 10, and I will write down 0 and carry 1 here, carry 1, and here is 1, 1 plus 1, it's 0, I carry 1 again, and it's 1, 1. So 12, it looks, it's 1, 1, 0, 0. Okay, next, 13, it's 1, 1, 0, 1. 14, one, one, and what is next?
One.
1 0. 1 0. Do you agree, Salome?
Yes.
And finally, 15. 15 we already know because it's special case, 15. It's less than 16, and 16 is 2 in the power 4 by 1. So this is 4 ones. And we will discuss, when we will discuss hexadecimal system, this number, we will denote it. We have not enough digits. We have 10 digits, but we want 16 digits. So we will denote it by A, B, C, D, E, and F. And we will use it in the hexadecimal system. And by the way, in the hexadecimal system, if we want to, if we want in the hexadecimal system to convert from the hexadecimal to decimal system, we can act in the same way. For instance, 3AB in the hexadecimal system, and we need to convert it in the decimal, we will act this in the same way. It's going to be 3 times 16 in the power 2, because we have 3 digit numbers, plus 10 times 16 in the power 1, and finally B, it's 11, and 11 multiplied by 16 in the power 0. Okay. Now, let's now go forward. Now, for instance, we have, decimal number. For example, 200. 8, and we want to convert it, we want to convert it in the decimal system. Maybe some of you know that we have some ways to convert it in the binary system, and but I like more to represent it as powers of 2. By the way, it's very useful to know the powers of 2. So we know 2 in the power 3, it's 8. 2 in the power 4, it's 16. 2 in the power 5, it's 32. 2 in the power 6, 64. 2 in the power 7, it's 2 in the power 8. Just a minute. Is 256. It's 256. 2 in the power 9, it's 512. And finally, 2010, it's 1024. So, there is several ways to convert it. We can divide it by 2 and then find decimal representation by remainders. But I more like to represent it as powers of 2. 208. What do you think? What is the largest power of 2 here? It looks it's 208. It's less than 256. So I can write here 228. Okay. Then 228 plus, if I will subtract here 228, what is it?
80.
Yes, it's 80.
So it's 64 and 16.
Yes, absolutely. You got it absolutely right. So it's 128 plus 64 plus 64 plus 64 plus what?
16.
64 plus 16. Okay, now I know that this is 2 in the power 2 in the power 7. This is 2 in the power 6, and this is 2 in the power 4. So from here, how many digits in the binary system we have here? What do you think in advance? How many digits we have here?
8.
Yes, absolutely, exactly, absolutely right. Why 8? How can you explain that we have 8? Because here, biggest power of 2, it's 7. And when biggest power of 2 is 7, it means we have 8-digit binary numbers. Okay, and let's now write down this number. First, it's 8. Then, it's 1. I will write down here 1. Next one. Then, I have no 2 in the power 5. That's why I will write down here 0. Okay, then, we have 2 in the power 4, and we have here 1. And now I should write down here how many zeros, because I skip powers of 3, 2, 1, 0. We missed 4 powers. So we need here to write down 4 zeros. Okay, one more example, please, and be very active. For example, we need to convert number. For example, we need to convert number number 300. Please start to convert it, and I will follow you. Which power is close with 300?
8.
Yes, 2 in the power 8. So we have here 256. 256, and we need to add 256. What?
32.
2 to the power of 5.
Okay, 32. Do you mean 32? Yes.
Yes.
So, okay, let's subtract here 356, and it's 44. And 44 also, we can subtract here 32, and we have 12. And from the 12, we can subtract 8, and we have 4. So, what can we now write down here? 256, next it's 32. Plus 8 and plus 4. Do you agree? Is it correct?
Yes.
Okay. Now I know that 256 is 2 in the power 8. This is 2 in the power 5. This is 2 in the power 3. 2 in the power 2, and in the end, I missed here 2 in the power 1 and 2 in the power 0. Okay, now let's write down it in the binary system. Please write down it and I will follow you. How many digits we have? How many digits we need to write down it?
9.
Yes, Diana. We have 9 digits. We need 9 digits here. And because highest power, it's 8. So let's write down 1. Then here we skip. We have here 2 zeros. Because we missed 2 in the power 7 and 2 in the power 6. So we missed here 0, 0. Then we have 1. We missed again 2 in the power 4 and we have 0. 1, 1, and?
2 zeros,
absolutely. So this is binary representation. It's binary representation of number 13. Okay, very good. Now, how to add numbers? For instance, we need to add numbers. For example, we need to add numbers 1, 1, 0, 1 and 1, 1, 1 in the binary system. So here both numbers are in the binary system. Okay, we know how to add. It's very similar what we did. What we did in elementary school for decimal numbers, it's very similar. 1 plus 1, it's 1, 0, and I write down 0 and carry 1. I carry 1 here, 1 plus 1, it's again, I will write down 0 and carry 1. 1 plus 1, it's 0, but my 1, it's 1. And here, we have also carry one, and here it's will be 1 and 0. Please look very critically and let me know, agree or disagree. Look very critically. Okay, let's repeat again. 1 plus 1, it's 1, 0. I wrote down 0 and carry 1. Then I have here 0, but I have my carry 1 and 1 in my RAM. I have 1. So 1 plus 1, it's 0, 1, and I carry 1 again here. I missed here to write down. And 1 plus 1. It's 1, 0. Please let me know, agree or disagree.
Yes, I agree.
Agree or disagree? Answer is yes. It's tautology. But I mean, okay. Any questions so far? Any questions so far?
No.
Okay. Okay. Now, let's know how to subtract. How to subtract. Subtraction also is very similar with decimal numbers, what you know in the decimal number system. And let's now write down the following example: 1, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 1, 1. So we can subtract 1 from the 0, but we can borrow 1. And do you remember in the decimal system, and of course you remember it, for example, in the decimal system, when we have 500, 5,000, for example, and if we subtract here 2 in the decimal system, we borrow from 5, 1, from borrow, we borrow from 1, and 10 minus 2, it's 8. But here, in the zeros, zeros will be replaced by 9. And our answer is, here we have 9, 9, and 4 instead 5, because we borrow 1. The same, very similar, we have here. We borrow from this 1, and what we have here, this is 1, because if we borrowed, and we have here binary 10, and 10 minus 1, it's 1, and here, instead zeros, instead both zeros, we have 1s. But here now, I have 0, because it was 1, but we borrowed it. So it's 1, here we have a 0, here is a 1. Now here again, we have 0 minus 1, and we will borrow from previous, we will borrow for preceding 1, and it will be 1. So this is our result of our subtraction. please, if any questions. Is it clear?
Yes.
Okay, very good. And now I will send now a file in the chat. And in the chat now I will send file. I sent, this is a PDF file, and the title is Lecture 5, Problems. Please find it in the chat, and download it. Now we will do some exercises to warm up. Did you find it?
Yes.
Okay. I have it as well. Okay. So let's start exercise 2-5. And for example, we have, number 3. In the number 3, we have, decimal number 287. And let's represent it in the binary system. Let's represent it in the binary system. Any idea how can we represent it? Which power of 2 is closer?
8.
Yes. Or in other words, 256. 256, okay. And what we should add, 256? It looks
31.
Also 31, I can represent as 16 plus 15. And 15 also we can represent it as 8 plus 7. And 7 we can represent as 4 plus 3. And 3 we can represent as 2 plus 1. 2 plus 2 in the power 0. Okay, now let's indicate powers. This is 2 in the power 5, 2 in the power 4, 2 in the power 3, 2 in the power 2, 2 in the power 1, and here we have 2 in the power 0. Okay. Oh no, I made here a mistake. It's not 2 in the power 5, but it's 2 in the power
8.
8. It's 2 to the power 8. It's 2 to the power 8. Okay, and now let's write down our binary number. It will 9-digit numbers. It will be 9-digit number. So it's 1. Then we skip here 7, 6, 5. We have 3 zeros. 0, 0, 0, and then we have no missing number, so we have then 1, 2, 3, 4. We have now 5 ones. Do you agree?
Yes.
Okay, very good. Okay, next, please, it's 18, how to subtract. But let's first, example 14, about addition. 14. So we have here 1, 1, 1, 1, and 1 plus 1, 1 plus 1 is 0, and we have here extra 1, 1 plus 1 is 0. And again, here we have an extra 1. This is 1, 1, 0. Please look critically and let me know, agree or disagree.
Agree.
Okay, very good. Very good. I hope all of you are in good mood and you are fresh. Okay, do we need about subtraction and addition some example? Okay, I think it's clear for you. And if will be any questions, you can ask later. And by the way, I told, and it's indicated in the syllabus, that on the Tuesday, from 12 to 14, we have teaching hours, and I'm always online on Zoom, and you can join anytime. Okay, now here is one very interesting example. Number 21. 21, it's about digital circuit. And in this digital circuit, we will use addition for binary numbers. But first of all, here is two type of gates. We know one of them, and we know what is and. But here is gates half adder. And this half adder, I will explain now what is this half adder. This is a logical gate, and it has 2 input and 2 output. And it's different. Logical gates add and gates what we discussed in the previous class. They had 1 output. But this half adder, it has two input and two output. And now one output, it's denoted basically by C, and another output denoted by S. And this S, it means sum, and this means carry. Okay, now, what is now and what will be output? How to find these outputs? For example, here, both inputs are one. Okay, we know very well that 1 plus 1 in the binary, it's 1, 0. So, 1 plus 1 is 1, 0, and in this 10, this is carry. This is carry because we can't write here 10. Because we can use here only 2 digits, 1 and 0. So this 10 is carry, and that's why this output here, it will be 0. Oh, sorry, it will be 1. Because carry, we have here carry, and carry is 1. Just a minute. This is 1. And as for another output, this is sum, but without carry. Without carry, so it's 0. Okay, let's, to be more clear, let's discuss, let's consider other example. And for example, we have other inputs. And for example, we have here 0 and 0. In this case, you know very well, 0 plus 0, it's 0. So we have here sum is 0 and carry is also 0. So in both cases here, we have 0, 0. Okay. Now let's here be 1. This input be 1. And this input, let's this input be 0. Okay, in this case, we have 1 plus 0, and 1 plus 0 is 1, and here no carry. That's why carry is 0, and this is 1. Is it clear? So this is nature of half adder gate. Now, here in this example, and this is 21. In the 21, here we have given. Here is 3 examples. Here is 3 problems in this one. And now, let's now discuss. Our goal is to find output signals. Our goal is to find output signals. So I will try to draw it. And you think to find and meanwhile, I'm now will draw it. And meanwhile, you think what will be outputs in first case. So here we need to find 2 outputs. So this is AND, and this is half adder. This is also half a day. Okay, here we have P, Q, R, and here we have two outputs, one of them we denoted by C1 and another by S1. Okay, and here also we have C2 output from here, and output from here it's S2. It's not very nice what I sketched, but however, we will try to, I will try to help us to solve it. Okay, let's now start. And what we have, we know P is one here, Q is one, and R is one. Okay, what output we have here? What is C1? C1, I mean this. What will be C1? So to find C1, what we need? We need to add 1 plus 1. So it's 0. I will write in this view. It's 0 and we carry 1. So here C1, it's going to be 1. And S, its sum, it's 0. Okay. Now, please let me know what is output from the another half adder, second half adder. What will be output here? Inputs here are 0 and 1. What will be carry?
0.
Absolutely. Very good. Very good. It's 0. Okay. And what will be another output?
1.
Absolutely. Very good. This is 1. Okay. So we already found this output. We already found this output. And now we will try to find another output. Another output here denoted by S, and we need now to find this output. So this is ordinary gates AND, and here we have two inputs, 1 and 0, and of course output here will be what?
0.
Of course, 0, because we know gates AND, it has output 1 only in one case when both inputs are 1. So we solved it. It's 1 and 0. Okay. Now here is all two more examples, and I hope you will successfully solve it independently as homework. But now I want now to start talking, and we will continue in the next class, to start talking about how integers can be represented in the computer, we will consider 8-bit representation. 8-bit, because it's very similar. All representations are very similar, and we will discuss about 8-bit representation. So here we have two type of representation. One type of representation is when we have, for instance, we have 8-bit. So we have 8 bit, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay. We have 8 bit, and we have two type of representation. One type of representation, it's called sine magnitude representation. Sine magnitude representation. Sine representation. When it does matter, it's positive number or negative number. And a more simple case, when we need to represent a number and don't pay attention to sign. Or in other words, we have only positive numbers. Okay, let me ask, if we want to represent positive integer, but non-negative. And what is the difference between positive and non-negative? Positive is 1, 2, 3, and so on. And non-negative, it means 0, 1, 2, and so on. So non-negative, it means it includes 0. So for example, we need to represent non-negative numbers without sign. 0, 1, 2, and so on. Okay, what do you think in 8-bit memory, how many numbers we can represent? How many non-negative numbers and in the binary system? Andrew, can you explain?
Because 2 to the power 8 is 256, and half of 8 is negative, and 1 is 0, and another...
No, we not consider, negative numbers. We discuss now representation without sign, no sign there. No sign, it means we have 0 and positive numbers. So, and Andrew, so you think we can here represent 2 in the power 8? Yes?
No.
256. Any other opinion?
No, we can't because we are lacking 1 bit.
We are lacking what, Nika?
1 bit. Like we need 9 cells to represent this.
Yes, but we have only 8 cells. We have only 8 cells and we need to represent number. Okay. What will be smallest number here, what we can represent? Smallest number, it will be all zeros.
Zero.
All zeros. It's zero. It's ordinary zero. Okay. What will be biggest number here?
One.
In this only ones. One. 8 ones. Okay. And 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1. It's 255. So, biggest number is 255 plus 1, that is 0. So Andrew is absolutely right. Here we can represent 256 numbers. Okay. Now, let's now think how many numbers we can represent if we will take in account sign. So it's called sine magnitude representation. In this case, it looks natural that first first cell assigned to sign, and for example, zero denote by zero denote plus, and by one denote minus, and another seven cells. We have here seven cells. Another seven cells to assign numbers. Okay. In this case, what will be biggest number? Biggest number in this case will be one and, biggest number it will be. So in this representation, zero, it just means plus. So biggest number here is zero, one, 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 zero and one, seven. And what is this number? It's a decimal. What is this number?
127.
127, yes. Because we know that this is special number, seven ones, and seven ones, it can be represented as 2 in the power 7, 7 minus 1 in the decimal. So it's 127. Okay. What will be smallest number? Smallest number we can write down as 1. It just means minus, and 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1. What will be this number?
Why so is it's minus 1? It isn't minus 1?
From here, minus, here one, first one, it just means minus. And in other cells, we have ordinary binary number. And this is minus, and this is 127. So smallest number here is minus 127. Okay, now let's count how many numbers can we represent. We can represent 1,000 positive numbers plus, 127 positive number, 127 negative number, and plus zero. How many numbers we can represent in this way? We can represent 255 numbers. So we lost one number because in 8-bit memory, there we have space for 256 numbers. What do you think? Why we lost one cell?
We have two zeros, minus zero.
Oh, absolutely zero. Right, Salome. Salome is absolutely right. Because here we have two zeros. One zero, it started with zero, and another zero, it started by one. So this representation, this way, why it's not used in computers. But what used? They are used representation, and this representation is called 2's complement. It's called 2's complement. And what is 2's complement? We will discuss it in the next class. So thanks for joining. If any questions you can ask, you can join me on Tuesday from 12 to 14. And if no questions, let's finish for today. And I will see you after tomorrow, 10 a.m.
Goodbye.
Goodbye.
Bye.
Bye. Thanks for joining.
Bye.
Bye.
Bye. Bye.